Sea level rise experts from around the world will converge on the ancient city to talk flooding.
Action News Jack's Lorena England explains. She talked to the city manager in St. Augustine, who says this conference could give them the boost they need to protect history.
St. Augustine may be small, but it's been front and center when it comes to discussions about rising sea levels. This weekend, it'll be front and center yet again as it hosts a national conference called Keeping History Above Water. City Manager John Reagan says the spotlight is now on St. Augustine.
It brings up our status as a community that's worth protecting at a national level.
Action News Jax has for years covered flooding issues in St. Augustine, from nuisance flooding to hurricanes like Matthew and Irma. Enid Fitzpatrick Kramer, who lives in Davis Shores, knows firsthand what it's like.
It is such a shock that you walk into your house and you see it completely flooded.
City leaders aren't afraid to be vocal about the need to do something to make the city stronger, and some projects are already underway.
Some projects that are defensive in nature, such as a project that we're doing in the downtown area with the Maria Sanchez.
One of the areas that deals with that nuisance flooding is right here by the Castillo de San Marcos. I've actually seen this parking lot right here flooded out even during a regular rainstorm. In order to fix that problem, here's what it's going to take: money, and a lot of it.
The solutions to St. Augustine could easily be north of $200 million.
An unreachable price tag for a city with an annual budget of $55 million.
We're going to need grants and outside resources from the federal government, state government.
The conference begins on Sunday with a presentation that's open to the public at the Lewis Auditorium. Lorena Inclan, CBS 47, Action News Jax.